become more of the real thing. Amen.
Let's get on our feet and praise God.
Overcame evil with
could, raised him to new life on the third day. And now you've called us to follow him, taking up the cross and relinquishing our lives, so that united with him, we may enter your life, a life which is worth more than the world itself. The night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread, gave thanks to you, broke the bread, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Take it, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this as often as you eat it in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup, gave thanks to you, gave it to the disciples, and said, "Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." And so, in remembrance of these your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ is coming again. Pour out your Holy Spirit on us gathered here, and on these gifts of bread and wine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world, until Christ comes in final victory, and we feast at his heavenly banquet. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and your Holy Church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. Now, with the confidence of the children of God, let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. As you come this morning, I invite first of all those who are helping to serve to come here tonight. And as they come, I would remind all of us, or have you know, that in the United Methodist Church, this is an open table, meaning that all people are welcome to come seeking God's grace, God's unconditional love, and desire to walk in newness of life. It doesn't matter whether you belong to any church or what church that might be, but that you simply desire the grace and love that God has for you, and to let your life be guided by that grace. We do serve grape juice rather than wine. There are gluten-free elements available to those who will simply let us know that you need them, and if you need to receive them, gain an usher's attention, and we'll make sure to come and serve you there. We want everyone to be included and none to be excluded, reflective of the love of God and Christ for us, that all might be included in that love, that all might be able to praise God for God's grace. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. They empower us to be a people who are different, whose minds are renewed and changed and transformed, and in that spirit I invite you to come and receive the gifts today. Thank you. forget after we're done. You can do it. There you go. Don't pull anybody apart. Don't forget, there's stuff to eat and drink over here. Coffee Connections right through that door after we're done. Whether you're an old friend or a new friend, we're glad you're here. There's a time to visit there and to enjoy each other if you've got a few extra minutes today. I hope that you will do that. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you peace now and always. Amen.
Thank you.